Hey, I'm Jake, and I'm excited to introduce Lobe, a new way to build machine learning models with an easy-to-use app. You know, machine learning is such a transformative tool. It's redefining how we build software, and even allowing us to do things with technology that, just a few years ago, we didn't think were possible. The problem is, machine learning's complicated, and that means right now it's only being used by a small group of experts. But we think machine learning should be a tool that can be used by anyone. And that's why we created Lobe. Lobe is an easy-to-use app that has everything you need to bring your machine learning ideas to life. It doesn't require any experience to get started. You can train on your own computer for free and ship your model on any platform you'd like. In the next few minutes, we'll use Lobe to train a custom machine learning model that can automatically detect when you take a sip of water. And we'll integrate this model into a health app that can remind us if we forget to drink enough water throughout the day. Okay, let's get started. So this is Lobe. Let's go up here and call this project Drink Tracker. Now, the really cool thing about machine learning is that it learns from examples. So all we need to do to get started is show Lobe some images of us drinking water, and it will start to train us a custom machine learning model. So let's go up here and import some images. If you already have images on your computer, you can import and label them right inside Lobe. But since we don't have any yet, let's use our webcam. All right, here I am. Now we'll take some pictures of us drinking for our model to learn. To do that, I'll go down here and label this drinking and take a few pictures. To collect pictures more quickly, we can press and hold on the shutter button to take a burst of images. Let's do that. And since I don't only drink out of this hand, I'll take pictures drinking out of my other hand as well for our model to learn that too. Okay, nice. The exact number of images you'll need will vary based on the complexity of your project, but it's always important to add a variety of images that include things like different poses, backgrounds, or lighting conditions. Really anything your model might see when being used in your app. All right, now that we've shown Lobe what it looks like when we're drinking, we also want to show Lobe what it looks like when we're not drinking. So let's go down here and label this not drinking and take pictures in front of our computer. I could get closer, maybe look around. Maybe I'm thinking. Really anything we would do in front of our computer. All right. That should be enough. Here we can view and browse all of the images we just took. And over here on the side, you can see our labels and how many images we have per label. You can also click on a label to see just those images. And if you want to make any changes, you can always click on a label to edit it or delete an image you don't want. But this is looking pretty good. Okay, so now that we've finished collecting and labeling images, the next step is to train our model. And one great thing about Lobe is training happens automatically in the background without any setup or configuration. And that means training just finished. Let's click on train and see how our model is doing. Here we can see the results of our trained model and the predictions it's made for all of our images. Up here with green labels are the images our model is predicting correctly. And down here with red labels are the images our model is predicting incorrectly. This can really help us discover our model's strengths and weaknesses and find areas to improve it. Like for these images, this is interesting. It looks like our model thinks I'm drinking whenever it sees my hand, even if there's not a cup. That might be because my hand is holding the cup in all the images where I'm drinking. It's important to keep in mind that machine learning may not always learn in the way you'd expect. Here it may have learned to focus more on my hand instead of the cup. We'll see if we can fix that in a moment, but overall it's predicting most of our images right. So why don't we click on play and try it out? Here we can use our webcam to see live predictions from the model we just created. Down here in the corner is the prediction, and it looks like it's correctly predicting that we're not drinking water. Now let's try it out and see if it can detect when we take a sip of water. Okay, correctly predicted that we're drinking there. Let me try my other hand as well. All right, looks like it could see that we're drinking there too. Next, let's try something out that confused our model, like when I put my hand to my face. Okay, yeah, it looks like it's still confused here and thinks when it sees my hand, I'm drinking. Now, one of my favorite things about Lobe is we can give our model feedback about the predictions it's making using these buttons over here in this corner and instantly improve it. So I can put my hand back up and find when it's making a mistake. I could then click this red button to tell Lobe that this is an incorrect prediction. Lobe will take that image along with the correct label and immediately retrain us a new model in the background. Okay, let's see if it's improved. I can bring my hand back up and it's no longer thinking I'm drinking. Awesome. Next, let's try something else that might confuse our model. Like, what if I bring my cup up? Okay. It might be that our model trained to find the cup well, but not actually detect when I'm really taking a drink of water. Let's see if we can improve that as well. I can go over here and tell Lobe that this is incorrect and I'm not drinking. I can try it over here with my other hand. And how about if I hold my cup in the front? Okay, perfect. Say that this is not drinking. It's important for our drink tracking app to make sure the model only detects when we're actually taking a drink of water, not just holding the cup up. We'll let this finish up. All right, let's try it out again. I can bring my cup back up and see that it doesn't think I'm drinking anymore. Let me try with my other hand and take another sip. Okay, great, got that right. Let me see if you can see over here as well. All right, our model's working much better now. This is pretty incredible. I mean, in just a few minutes, we were able to collect and label images, train a custom machine learning model, try it out, and improve it, all inside Lobe. Now, this is just the start, and as we look to improve our model more, we'll want to continually add more examples to show it more things like different people, or a variety of cups, or more backgrounds. But for this first version of our model, this should work great for me at my desk. So why don't we export it and integrate it into our health app? All right, so let's go up here and export. Lobe allows you to export to a variety of formats and ship your model on any platform you'd like. Because we're building a cross-platform app, let's use TensorFlow. And we'll just save this to our desktop. Lobe additionally gives you the option to optimize your model before exporting. This will train your model longer if Lobe can find improvements to make it run even better in your app. So let's optimize and export our model. Okay, so once the model finishes exporting, you can easily add it to any app you're building. I've already coded our health app and integrated the model we just trained into it. So let's go try it out. We can go ahead and close Lobe and open up our drink tracking app up here. I built this app to run in the background and use our model to continually track when I drink water throughout the day. Up here on top, you can see how much water I've had so far. And down here is a nice little chart that shows how much water I've had at different hours. Now, what I really like about this app is if you forget to drink water for a period of time, it'll give you a gentle reminder. Like that. Why don't we take a sip and try it out? Okay, nice. You can even take a sip for longer. Okay, this is working great. This app will help me drink more water and develop healthier habits. We can even think about expanding this app to do more, like detect when I'm drinking soda or eating too much junk food. It's amazing to think how easy it was to add this kind of intelligence to our app. And this is just one example of the kind of things you can do with Lobe. You can start training your machine learning model today. Just download the app at lobe.ai. It's free to use and available for both Mac and PC. We can't wait to see all the amazing things people come up with as machine learning is made easy enough for anyone to use.